Hey guys, D1sco here, and this is attempt number 2 of this video, but today I'm reacting to the developer update March 2024. I had recorded this video initially a few days ago as of recording this now. This will be up a few days after I'm recording this version, assuming everything goes well. And I was unable to upload it for a few days, so that meant that I didn't know about the problem yet. So once I found out about the problem, while the video was like, you know, privated, I'm fixing it now. So, which kind of sucks because I had a, with one of the things, and we'll get to it, I did message Orange in the original video and asked him for his thoughts, and I will share those with you in attempt number 2 here when I get there. But yeah, so this is the March 2024 developer update. As of recording, this is been 20 minutes of April 1st. And though I do have a video scheduled for this day, well, sort of two, but one of them like was supposed to come out earlier. Basically, this picture here so the colors around the things shows how important it was. So the only major change was the twins rework. Blight got a minor change, although we'll get to it, but I would argue it is a major change because of how, like, because this is this, because it fixes a, well, it helps with a very big problem with Blight. We'll get there. Haddonfield got touched, as you can see, and it got a medium rework, which basically means kind of in the middle. And then the perks there are the Scissor Strike, which was just the only minor, and Adrenaline Ultimate Weapon that got medium. And there's new features. There's store improvements. They removed D-pips and they archives improvements. So let's jump in here, read, go into a bit more detail. Again, because this is my second attempt, I'll probably blaze through this a lot faster than I did. In my original video, I was geeking out over the twins changes because that's an amazing, like, a few other part and a few other things in here. I was like geeking out over how cool they were. But in this video, because I've already read everything, it has been a few days though, granted, I'm probably not gonna be geeking out as much, but just know that I'm excited for every single change in here, and I'm going to do my best to explain it, especially since this is attempt number 2. I'm hoping I can explain better than the attempt that you guys won't see. So spring has sprung, and so has a new developer update. In this post, we'll share everything we've been working on for our next update. As always, these changes will first head to the public test build or the PTB on Steam. We encourage you to give them a try if you can, and let us know what you think. I'm unaware if this is live or not yet. If it is, I'm hoping me and Orange can get a few things with my computer figured out first. I've had a few problems and I'm working to rectify those. I tried to fix for it today, didn't really work. I'm waiting to hear Orange's feedback, but anyways. So the twins here, which got the major update. So, right off the bat, they showed 5 things, and that kind of blew my mind. They did so much to the twins, it's kind of ridiculous. This is one of the most substantial major updates I've ever seen. Like, in my time of playing, this is one of, if not the biggest. So the first change that they did was they reduced the time it takes to switch back to Charlotte to 1.5 seconds was freezing. So basically what that means, and again, I was geeking out over all, I was like gushing over all of this before. So now you won't have to listen to that. Look at you guys. Basically all that means is when you're a victor, whether victor dies or you, well, probably, I'm assuming, victor quote-unquote dying by getting a pallet hit or, like, you know, someone ripping him off probably counts, but basically originally it took 3 seconds to go back to Charlotte, but now it's 1.5 seconds. They cut that in half, and I think that's a really good change because it allows No, that might be annoying to survivors because, I mean, obviously because a killer is getting it to, you know, getting touched. But overall, I think this is a better change. But I think this is a good, solid change for her, for the twins here, because it allows you from going to the Victor back to Charlotte. There's less time, so you can faster get, you know, catch up to the survivor or whatever. The second change is reduce the time it takes to unbind Victor to 0.5 seconds, was 1 second. So originally it took 1 second to, like, release him. Now it takes 0.5 seconds, which I feel like is better. The third change is reduce the time it takes to charge Victor's pounce to 0.85 seconds, was 1 second. So it's an even faster pounce charge. So the first new ability is they added the ability to recall Victor at any point while he's unbound. I think that's a huge change. I'm uncertain of how much I will play the twins. I've never been good as twins. I like twins, but I've never been good. As something I am curious about, though, however, is Orange. Because Orange has gotten one adept twins. It was my PS4, and it was kind of, honestly, a little lucky. He used Victor, like, once. But I am curious, because since Orange is the killer main, and I just suck. I'm just dog shit at the game entirely, and he's actually good at a side. But I'm very curious how the killer main Orange, he might leave a comment on this video if he sees it. If he does, I'd love for him to kind of, I'd love to see him leave a comment basically giving his thoughts on the changes and how he thinks he'll do with them. I would love to eventually do, it would be really cool to do some add-up videos of some add-up attempts with the twins, where Orange can show off his awesome gamer skills and how, and try them out and just see what he thinks about it. There's only one add-up we are absolutely scared about, and that's and I don't know if we're ever getting that one, but this one I feel like is more manageable, but we shall see. So the last new ability that they added is they added the ability to change between Victor and Charlotte near a hooked survivor, because you couldn't do that before. If I'm remembering correctly, before it just wouldn't work. If you did, it was like you were, it was basically just saying that, like, the game was basically just telling you you're too close. Another thing that was cool was they added developer notes to every single thing, which allows you to get more of an idea of, like, their thought process. So the first developer note here says, we have made switching between Charlotte and Victor more responsive, and given the killer the ability to recall Victor at any time, so they feel better to play. Be warned, the anti-face camp editor will still feel if you're too close. So obviously be careful about that. So the next change was Charlotte. This is not a new thing. I will say if it's new, because it says change or new. So the next change was they updated 7 add-ons. They do not tell you at all what the add-ons are, but I do think it's a good thing updating add-ons, because from my understanding, most, if not all, of the twins add-ons suck, like, are not great, and so that's good. The second change here is in this section, this will be, like, the 7th change, you know. Victor's pounce no longer latches on the healthy survivors. We'll get to the developer update. They explain that more in depth. I do feel like that is somewhat of a good change, because it allows, because there's not much of a point to have him latch on that early. I mean, I guess there is, but you know what I mean? Usually survivors are able to just rip him off and be the zazz. So the third change in this section before we get to the new stuff is Victor can no longer be kicked after successful pounces which do not last onto a survivor. So I've never pulled that off, but originally you could, like, kick him, like, if he's on the ground and he, like, misses his pounce or whatever, you could kick him. and he would just die. Well, you know, I mean, he comes back, but it's weird because Victor's like the only killer you can technically kill. But it's weird. Anyway, so the next new change. So this is the first new change in this section here. And from what I remember, it's a pretty solid one. So Victor's pounce now latches onto survivors when they are put into the dying state. Other survivors can crush Victor during this to help the dying survivor. Victor will automatically return to Charlotte after 20 seconds. So if you kill him at that point, he goes back to Charlotte after 20 seconds. I think that's a good change. I don't fully understand why you would want Victor to be latched onto a down survivor. I guess I'm sure they have the reason for that, and I'll be interested in seeing Udder's feedback on that, like basically other people's opinions on that. And I'm very interested to see what they do with twins after the PTB. I just think that's interesting as all. I do kind of like how Udders can help you though if they do. The next new change is while Victor is attached to a survivor or holding a survivor in a locker. Apparently that's a thing you can do, I don't know. I don't see twins very often, nor do I. So I don't fully understand how, so I don't fully know everything that they can do. Charlotte gains a 10% haste effect. This effect will be lost prematurely if Charlotte hits a survivor. I think that's a pretty good change. Because sometimes Victor can get pretty far from Charlotte, so that haste allows, you know, her to catch up, which I think is good. Oh yeah, and they removed a thing. This is the only thing they removed for twins, but they removed the thing. So what they removed was survivors near Victor while he's latched onto another survivor are no longer revealed by Killer Instinct. And I think that's good because it doesn't really, they don't really need to, you know, be pop up. Sorry, just messaging the boy orange back real quick. While I'm here, where was it? Oh, found it. So, I'll need that later, but anyways. So the developer update for this section is previously the twins' power heavily encouraged slugging, leaving survivors in the dying state. Since Victor could chain together pounces on multiple injured survivors, but only pounce a single healthy one. Furthermore, survivors could often save each other before Charlotte could make it to them. So before I finish reading that, I want to give you guys an example of the twin slugging in action, because me, Orange, and two other people experienced it one time, and it was I hated this. So what happened was we were going up against a twins player who was who only used Victor, and they pounced. Anyways, Victor pounced on me and then dropped me, right? So I'm in the dying state. Someone had run over to pick me up, and this is what was frustrating about. I got picked up, and then I immediately went into the dying state again. And then Victor then downed, like, somebody else. Orange had picked me up at one point, and then Victor hit him as he was trying to heal me. And I believe he got me up and then got downed. And then I went down again. Basically, what happened was exactly like what they were describing. Victor slugged all of us. We were all down on the dying state. And the twins player was unsuccessful in hooking everybody. They hooked me, or no, sorry. They hooked Orange and the other person. Somebody I think DC'd, and then I just bled out because I think me and the other person ended up like bleeding out because our timers were so low, especially mine, because I kept being in the dying state, so my power timer was low. But yeah, that's just an example of why this change happened. That is the example. That is the playstyle they wanted to get rid of. And something that I find interesting about behavior with Dead by Daylight, unlike some other companies and like with their games, is that behavior tries to get rid of those annoying playstyles, right? They've been trying to get rid of slugging and face camping and, you know, and then just and tunneling. They're trying to get rid of this annoying twins playstyle. They got rid of that one pig playstyle that people found annoying, and like a few others are gone. So I'm very happy that twins now can't do that, because I remember me and Orange, because obviously we can't hear the other two, we're very upset about it, because, and understandably so, like, you want to play the video game, and then that garbage happens where you can't even play the video game because you're just getting downed by Victor the whole time, and then you all bleed out and die, like, very early. It's like, yeah, okay. You know, anyways, before I go on a very long rant and tangent, I'm going to shut up and I'm going to stop that conversation now. We have flipped this around. Victor will now be much more effective at injuring multiple survivors, which is why they gave the changes that they did, that I read. They want Victor to be able to just start injuring people instead of, like, slugging. Obviously, that sounds like the same thing. We're getting there. Survivors instead assist Charlotte. They're supposed to be a team, and so with these changes, they're hoping to better kind of show off their teamwork, because before you could just play Victor and Slug and win the game, or you could pull an Orange and just play Charlotte pretty much almost the entire game and win because you're just such a absolute Chad. I really hope you watched this video, Orange. I'm giving you all the hype right now. Who now moves faster while Victor is latched on. So maybe that's also part of it, because, like, when you down someone and he's, like, latched on, you get that haze. Maybe that's part of it. Picking out the survivor, this makes it possible for Victor to both injure and down a survivor without being forced to switch back to Charlotte in between. They have an understandable change. So there's two more changes. So the first new change is the visual Terry's accessibility sinks without Victor's grunts. And the second and final change in general for twins is Victor will now glow red whenever he is vulnerable to being crushed. This developer notes us, we have updated the visual terrace to include Victor's grunts to improve accessibility and added a red glow to Victor whenever he is vulnerable to being crushed to improve visual feedback. The Blight, who got a minor change according to behavior, but not to me. Change. Improved collision detection to reduce cases where the blight slides off objects. I don't know if you guys understand how crazy good that is. Well, I'll read the developer update and then I'm going to go on a small rant, on a small tangent, and just explaining why I am so excited. Developer note, it could be frustrating to slide off an object you were trying to bump into and enter rust prematurely. We have improved the collision detection to make the blight's rush more consistent. This also fixes an issue which allowed the blight to incorrectly slide along obstacles and lunge around tighter corners than intended. So let me go on my small tangent. So Orange is actually not that bad as a blight main. I'm not saying he is a blight main. I am just saying that he has done not terribly as blight many times in the past. And I've watched him play blight a lot, and I have seen others play blight. And you notice the slide, like, originally, like, you can notice the slide multiple times when Orange was playing Blight, either for a thing for me on one of my accounts or for himself, and I just happened to be watching him. You could tell it was frustrating because he would go to hit, say, some boxes, and instead of hitting the boxes and keeping, you know, the rush going, he kind of hit the boxes but slide off, which ends his rush, and of course, which ends up ending the rush and, you know, just super frustrating. This change, I feel like, in my opinion, shouldn't be minor because it fixes a huge problem with Blight. That is one of the biggest problems with Blight. And if you, and so them, like, you know, I'm not saying this will fully fix the problem, but this change is so nice. I love it so much. I'm sure Orange will love it. It, maybe he'll leave a comment if he ends up watching this video. I did kind of ask him to earlier, but whatever. We'll see what happens. I'm not even sure what the last video on the show he saw was, but it doesn't matter. The point is he will be excited. I'm hella excited. Other blight mains should be excited. This just solves such a... doesn't solve. It really helps a major problem. And I can't wait to see how he comes out of this. Haddonfield, which got a medium update. So Haddonfield is kind of a long section. Twins has the longest section because they did over 10 changes, some of which were new, one of which was a removal, and quite a few changes. So understandably, Twins, who got that much attention, will have the most stuff. But Haddonfield has a ton as well. So as you can see, there's four changes with Haddonfield. The first change, at least that we can currently see. The first change is updated map layout and reduced the overall size. So they get to it later, but they wanted to make... but because this map is kind of big and there's a lot of, like, dead parts, they reduced the overall size to get rid of some of that dead space. And then they update the map layout to make it as well to... fix up some, like, dead spaces. Change. This is the second change. Reduce the length of hedges and fences to create more openings. They get to it at some point later, but they do mention how frustrating that, like, but they do mention how, like, that was intended to, like, basically that's intended because the hedges are very long and some of the fences as well. So that's meant to just kind of give you, like, more options to move, you know. The developer note, the map's long and narrow shape and rows of unbroken fences and or hedges made getting around very time consuming. Yes. It also made chases, like, harder in some ways, because if you're not skilled at, like, juking the killer and whatnot, you're just kind of out of luck because you can't really vault much. If that makes sense. We have reduced the overall size and added more openings to make it easier to traverse. Next change. So this is change number 3. Adjusted various houses to reduce the strength of strong loops, and of course, which is obviously a good thing. And of course, the final change that we can currently see, because I think there might potentially be more, reduced the number of houses in the map, already meaning houses can be entered. So I remember... let me just read the developer note. Many houses were closed off, yes, making the map larger without any room for gameplay. We have reduced the number of houses that spawn, though each one that remains will now be open and playable. So basically, they're getting rid of the houses you can't enter to, one, reduce the size of the map, and two, just because you can't enter them, so they're just kind of there. So now the only houses that will be left will obviously be the... Myers house, the one with the pumpkin, the House of Pain, as we call it, and the other houses that you can actually enter. Where was I at? We both reduced the strength of some of the strongest window loops to be fair and more interesting to play. So I was right. I remember there being a pretty big section. So this is a new change. You guys ready for this? Added pallets and lockers along the edge of the map, because there's just nothing out there along at the edge. So that happened. So you fixed that problem to put something there, which I think is good. So the next change is updated straight tiles to feature more pallet loops, and the next change is adjust pallet loops in park tiles. So let me so we're finally at the end of the map of Haddonfield. But this is the last developer note was Haddonfield. The outdoor areas were fairly empty before. Yes. Encouraging survivors to make a run to the nearest house. Yes. When they were chased, since we've reduced the strength of houses, we have added some additional loops to the streets and edges of the map to spread out chases and reduce dead zones. So the way I think about it is you weaken the houses, but you buff up the outside to try to make it fair. So like all the strength you're taking away from the houses, you're just moving that to the outside of the map. So it's still, it's not quite like that, but like that's kind of the way that kind of makes sense to me. So the slice of strike, which got a minor update. So I did not know until sometime after my attempt number one video, at Starva, the guy who pretty much everyone at least will listen, a guy whose opinion is highly valued, me and him have once again, well, okay, I wouldn't say disagree, it's more so he understands this a little bit better than I do. I think it's a decent change, but I do understand where Odds is coming from of not liking it, and I'm hoping that, depending on how people feel during the PTB with all these, which I don't know when that is, hopefully soon-ish, was it? It probably won't be. Well, they'll mention a PTB and I'll obviously read it, but so it'll be a bit probably. But so I'll be definitely interested in seeing how the size of strike comes out of the PTB. But so they changed and added something. So the first change was increased the stun duration to 5 seconds was 3 seconds. When they made it 3 seconds, that killed the perk. The size of strike was no more, and everybody got upset because that was the only, like, anti-tunneling thing we had. Though they, of course, nerfed that to hell back during the 40 perk rework, which is still, we're still very much in a 40 perk rework kind of era. So, if we're talking, like, just to give you, an idea, America, a lot of times America will be called, I've seen this in, like, a few, like, history things, and it's been mentioned at, like, in my school. So, like, a lot of times when talking about America nowadays, people will say, like, they kind of bring 9/11 into it, so they're always like, this post to 9/11 world is all like whatever. Like, I don't know why people do that, but they do. And so with the 40 perk rework, if you think of it like that, we very much live in a quite a bit different game coming out of the 40 perk rework. And unfortunately for me, the way that the game changed pretty much killed a lot of my skills, if you will. I've just gotten way more frustrated with the game after that. I'm not saying it's the game's fault, I'm just saying I'm having a hard time adapting to the changes and whatnot. But anyways, so increasing the stun duration is obviously good because it fixes that major issue which killed the perk to begin with. The problem is that that's not a whole lot of time, and we'll get to the developer note because they mentioned why they increased the time, but I understand where Ots is coming from and others who don't like this. So the new changes, they added a new stabbing animation when the Scythe Strike is used successfully. I don't think I've ever seen. I've used the Scythe Strike once or twice. I don't even remember what the old animation was. I think it was just you kind of like move your hands, and then it just kind of happens. I don't really remember, so I'm very excited to see the new animation. Developer notes, the survivor is locked in place for part of the stun, yes, while they are being dropped by the killer. Because apparently them being dropped by the killer counts as part of the perk's time, apparently. So it didn't leave them as much time to run away. Once they hit the ground, we have increased, which is a big reason why it died. By the time you hit the ground, you had like maybe 1 second. We have increased the duration of the stun to give the survivor a fair chance to create some distance. Now, in my original video, so attempt number one, I love that change. And I still think it's good that they want to give you survivors more of a chance to use that perk successfully. But I understand why some people don't like it. So I am trying to keep an open mind. I just think it's, if nothing else, a good thing that they want to give people more time. While we're at it, we add a new animation which plays when a survivor successfully uses Scythe Strike to break free and give some visual flair to the perk. So Adrenaline had an interesting change because they inadvertently buffed my motherfucking main, Freddy Krueger, bitches. Where my Freddy gang at? We got fucking buffed, bitch, AV. Let's fucking go. I'm so happy. We'll get to that because I do mention it. Freddy's my boy. I'm so happy. I'm so happy he got changed. I'm so happy he got inadvertently buffed by this. And I can't wait to play more Freddy, obviously. Hell yeah. First adrenaline change. Adrenaline no longer activates if you are hooked when the gates are powered. It did before. So now it won't activate if you're hooked when they get powered. The second change is they reduced the speed boost duration to 3 seconds plus 5 seconds, which I feel like is fair. Because adrenaline is a pretty powerful perk. Orange has, in many Dead by Daylight videos, you can hear him scream out of anguish, adrenaline, of course, or like, of course you have adrenaline, oh, of course, like, the point is adrenaline, if used successfully, can be a very annoying perk. If the killer main Orange is complaining a lot about it, and others are as well, I feel like that's a good, you know, indicator that the perk can be very annoying. So this, and I feel like these changes help alleviate some of that frustration and anger. Again, if Orange does end up watching this, very excited to read his comment. I'm sure it's going to be like 5 paragraphs long, but I will read as much of it as I can and try to respond to his comment. If he wants to respond to that, he can, but I'm very interested to see what Orange has to say. I wonder if, and maybe you guys are too, or maybe some of you, I don't know. The last change, which inadvertently buffed my boy, adrenaline no longer causes you to wake up when facing the nightmare. For some reason, it could do that, which does kind of make sense, because adrenaline does help keep you awake, because it really gets, like, the blood pumping and stuff. But now that that doesn't do that,
Freddy is slightly, like,
yeah, they get to it, but like that's a major thing for Freddy, because if someone has adrenaline, who knows if they will after this change. No, I'm kidding. I feel you could definitely still get value out of adrenaline, because they fix like a thing where it won't just be wasted if you get hooked, you know, right at that second. Yes, the speed boost is less, but you still get the effects, like some of the other effects. And of course, Freddy inadvertently getting buffed. I feel like people might still use adrenaline. There's no reason not to. The changes are solid. They fix some problems with it, just decreased, you know, the speed boost just because they felt like that was a problem. So the developer note says adrenaline had a lot of exceptions, which make it difficult to play around, as I'm sure Orange would agree with. If a survivor was hooked while the icy gates were powered, they would be healthy and receive a substantial speed boost upon being unhooked. Yep. Making it very difficult for the killer to catch them before they could escape. There we go. We have made it so adrenaline no longer pauses when you are on the hook. Finally, we've removed the wake-up effect from when facing the nightmare, aka Freddy Krueger. Happy birthday, bitch. To clean up the perk, as we've moved away from perks that affect specific killer powers over the years. Happy birthday to me, bitch. That makes me so happy. Because I believe a long time, I don't know how long we have to look back for the thing that they mentioned of perks that affect certain killer powers. But adrenaline was probably the last one there for a while that did. So the fact that that no longer does that, like, obviously, happy birthday to me, bitch. But, like, you know, happy birthday, bitch. Flipping love. I don't know why. Anytime we play Freddy, that's what it turns into, but I love it. But I'm very happy that adrenaline, it finally, like, we're done with that, right? It's gone, and it happened to inadvertently buff my boy a little bit, which is nice. But obviously, more importantly than inadvertently buffing my boy, it's nice that the effect that they don't really want to have in the game anymore, you know, it's gone. Ultimate Weapon had a weird one. Not necessarily bad, but I understand where they're coming from. I'm very interested in Orange's opinion on this one, because Ultimate Weapon is considered pretty good. Very excited to see what Orange has to say about this one, if he does end up watching this video. Ultimate Weapon change, and just so you know, there's no new effects, it's all changes like some of the other ones. Now reveals survivors' auras instead of causing them to scream. We'll get to the developer note. I feel like the developer update did do a decent job of explaining, so we'll get there. I think the aura, being able to see auras can be helpful. So I feel like it's a decent, I feel like it's not necessarily like a better or worse change, it's just different, you know. The second change is reduced activation time to 15 seconds, less 30 seconds. Now, before some of you people get very angry at behavior for that, because that means that the perk's gonna happen more often, let me read to you the third change. Increased cooldown to 80, 70, 60 seconds, less 40, 35, and 30 seconds. So yes, the activation time is shorter, but the perk now takes longer to come back. And now we finally get to the developer update, which will explain why they did this.
Ultimate Weapon with a checkbox change.
I'm so frustrated that I yawn so much in these videos, but like it's a lot of text. Yes, I'm interested, but just sitting here reading is only so interesting, even to me. So that's why I yawn a lot. But anyways, Ultimate Weapon was a jack of all trades, providing both information and a consistent way to interrupt survivors' actions, allowing it to synergize too well with other perks. Rather than screaming, survivors will instead after auras revealed. This means it will no longer interrupt survivors' interactions, so survivors won't know that they are being revealed to the killer. That's interesting, because being able to screw up survivors a lot is obviously a good thing for the killer. But I understand that that would be seen as, like, way too frustrating for the other side. So I'm very excited to see what, you know, so I think that's fair. Plus, aura can still be useful. So, like, it's just interesting, you know, is all I'm kind of saying. It's a very interesting perk change, in my opinion, because it's so, like, they did quite a bit. Since Ultimate Weapon is easy to activate, it was possible to keep its effects active throughout the entire match, which is another reason why they increased that timer on its cooldown. We have increased the cooldown and decreases the activation window to ensure some downtime between uses. So basically, the reason for doing both is reducing the activation time basically just means that it takes less time for it to activate with the tray. Like, basically, those two just kind of go hand in hand. So yes, it activates faster, but it will also take longer to cool down, which so it kind of like equals out a little bit to provide some downtime. Emblems. Minor update. Change. Remove the ability to lose a pip. Developer note. With emblems being used solely for monthly rewards these days, me and Orange would agree with that. Now, this is the part that I will read the message, some of the messages Orange had sent me regarding this, because I told them literally why I was filming the attempt of part, while I was filming attempt number one. And I even read the change in attempt number one, so I will share them in attempt number two with you all here today. Sorry that the video is so effing long, but like I hope I did a pretty good job explaining stuff. Anyways, so basically the reason for that is you get blood points at the end of every month. Orange has managed to get the iridescent like quite a bit as killer. I've managed to get the iridescent as survivor like twice. But the fact that now we can't lose pips, regardless of how hard the match was, the two of us could potentially get iridescent more often because we can't lose pips. So we can, like, the thing will, to like, the emblem, the, our rank will not change unless if we did good enough to increase the pip, to, like, gain a pip. So I feel like the two of us, and, so I'm very excited to see if the two of us can get all those achievements now regarding the emblems, because Orange is missing the final killer one, the iridescent one killer, and I think all but one of the survivor ones. I'm missing quite a bit of both, although he has helped me get like one or two of the killer ones. I think I'm missing all of the survivor ones though, just because it's so hard. But with that being said, I'm very excited about this change. It's so good. It's so good. It felt needlessly punishing to lose a pip. Because the reason why you lost a pip is because if I'm kind of remembering correctly, the game was kind of competitive at one point in time. Like, people took it way more seriously. Like, they wanted to get as high as they possibly could. And for your hard work, you got rewarded with the blood points. And I'm very happy that when they noticed that people kind of shifted away from being like all gung-ho, when people kind of shifted away from really taking it seriously, I'm very happy that they did not fully remove it, because they totally could have. I'm very happy that they didn't, though, because they understood how important those monthly rewards are for players. So they basically went, you know what? We'll fry you a bone. You'll keep your monthly rewards, and we'll make it easier to help you get them by removing a pretty big part of, the initial ring system. Because by doing that, getting rid of the ability to even lose pips is huge. For those monthly rewards, of course. I felt needlessly punching and losing a pip after a rough match. This quality of life change will make the emblem system less stressful. This also applies to modifiers. You can enjoy these limited time modes without worrying about your grade, which is super cool. And let me read what Orange has. So, my first message was, let's fucking go. So I'm texting you while filming because I need to tell you this. And that was, again, when I was filming attempt number one. Behaviors removing the ability to lose pips. Let's fucking go! Your response was, wait, really? That's amazing. Because it is. And then I told him pretty much what I just read to you guys. So I said, it's because I kid you not. No one cares and only uses emblems for monthly blood points. Which is the truth. That is the entire, that's literally the reason that was stated, and that's the reason in general. It was like 30 cents standard, and the game did shit. And of course, Orange kind of agreed that that's the only reason why he uses them, because most players, that is the truth. Sounds good. But yeah, that was all I had to read to you guys from. So, there you know his thoughts on it. Anyways. Whoops, I grabbed the mouse well, a little too late. Store. Major update. Store improvements. Change. Visual overhaul to the entire store menu. You can kind of see the picture. That's, I guess, what it's going to look like now. Because that's not how it... after this releases, because that's not how it looks like right now if you go into the game. New. Added specials tab to highlight items that are on sale. New. Added collection tab to find customizations from a specific collection. New. Added bundles containing multiple items at a discounted price. New. Killer Mori animations can now be viewed in the store. And finally, new. Added a weekly gift that can be claimed for free. The weekly gift alone, time number one, I was gushing over because I'm still very excited about that. But all the challenge, but all of them sound amazing. Death Note. The store hasn't changed much since it was introduced in 2018. That's still crazy to me to think that 2016 and 2017, aka the first 2 years of this game existing, there was just no store. Because the whole time I've been playing the game, because I didn't get the game until 2020, and then I didn't really start hardcore playing it until 2021. Or, sorry, 2022. 2021 would be when Orange started playing it. I didn't start playing it until 2022. And in that time, both of us played when there was a store. So so it's still wild to me to think that for the first 2 years, there just wasn't a store. This update makes it easier to find what you're looking for and allows us to bundle content together at a reduced price. For example, it's now possible to purchase an entire DLC pack for the in-game store rather than purchasing each character separately, which is not very nice. And as you guys can see, here's some pictures showing it off. And this is the final section, archives. The archives change. New towns and their respective rifts will now open at the same time after the update. And new rift bundle options, which grants the premium rift rewards and a 20-tier head start at a discounted price. Developer note, rifts have historically opened the day after our mid-chapter updates. But no more. You can now get cracking on the challenges right away. We have also introduced a new Rift bundle, which includes the Premium Rift Pass and 20 tiers at a discounted price. The Premium Rift can still be purchased separately if you prefer. Until next time, WWE team. So, final thoughts for attempt number two here, because I did that with attempt number one. It's amazing, in my opinion. The flipping, the twins changes alone are insanely incredible, and I can't wait for those alone. You add the flipping, no longer being able to de-pip or lose pips to that. And that's just another change on top of it. The store looks amazing, and a lot of those changes are so nice. And who knows, maybe they'll update the store in the future to give us like a charm section, which I know a lot of people have been wanting. And maybe they'll even give us like a badge and banner system as well, which I know people have been wanting. Plus, if you add those, you could potentially add like Rift, you know, like old Rift ones to the store, just like you do with Rift outfits, or some of the Rift outfits anyways. The blight change is amazing. It helps with a huge problem with blight, which is why I love it so much. If that makes sense. The Haddonfield change is very understandable, so I don't have too many, like, really any complaints about it. I think it's good. The archive changes are pretty good as well. I mean, they're just kind of doing what other games did with the whole Rift bundle thing, but that's fine. The Decisive Strike, I'm just happy that the behavior is trying to increase the amount of time for survivors after killing this perk like 2 years ago, 2 or 3 years ago. Ultimate Weapon has a pretty interesting change, and I can't wait to see how Ultimate Weapon after the PTB will like come out of that. Adrenaline sounds pretty fine to me, at least. So take that how you will. But like, there's not necessarily a bad thing in this one. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you liked it, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, share the video, ring the bell, do all the other garbage. It helps us out a lot and means a lot to us. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.